Now let us look at the issue of debentures at premium. Premium means the issue price is more than the face value. For example, the face value is just 100 rupees and the issue price is 105, then the debentures are said to be have been issued at a premium of rupees 5 per debenture. Let us look at this example. We are continuing the same example which was considered for issue of debentures at par, but the only change here is now the allotment money will be rupees 35 instead of rupees 30 because there is now a premium of rupees 5 per debenture. The application entry will remain the same because there is no change in application because we receive application money and we transfer so much to debentures. But in case of allotment money, we are collecting premium at the allotment stage. Therefore, while passing the due entry itself, we have to be very careful. If you notice here, debenture allotment account has been debited for 1000 debentures at rupees 35 because now it includes premium of 5. So this is nothing but an asset which is increasing. Since it is increasing, we have to debit it. So 35,000. Credit 10% debentures account. The liability in this case is the increasing with respect to debentures only by rupees 30 as the remaining 5 will now be treated as premium on issue of debentures. Therefore, it's a separate liability which is getting increased. So now we have two liabilities instead of one. One is the debentures, the other being securities premium account, which is nothing but the premium on debentures. Therefore, 30,000 and 5,000 accounted for separately. Then comes receipt of the same debit bank. It's a simple receipt entry, debit whatever comes in or debit increase in asset and credit decrease in asset debenture allotment because we are supposed to receive so much of money from the debenture holders and now we have received so much of money from them. Therefore, we no longer need to have this asset of debenture allotment account. Now let us look at issue of debentures at a discounted price. That means the issue price is less than the nominal value. So in this case, what we are doing is we are collecting the entire amount at the time of application itself. So the rupees 100 debentures are now being issued at rupees 90. Therefore, there is a discount of rupees 10. Receipt entry, debit bank account, because we are receiving money, 1000 debentures into rupees 90. Therefore, 90,000 is being debited, increase in asset to debenture application. Since it's the application stage, we have to credit application account. Since it's a liability, temporary liability increasing, therefore credit that 90,000. And transfer entry, debenture application, the same 90,000 is now being debited, decrease in liability. And then discount on issue of debentures. This is the loss or expense for the business 10,000 because instead of 1 lakh they have issued those debentures only at rupees 90,000. So therefore the remaining 10,000 will be loss and that loss is debited to discount on issue of debentures and credit 10% debentures. That's a liability which is increasing to the company. Debentures issued for consideration other than cash. That means we are receiving something else in return instead of cash. For example, sometimes it so happens that the company purchases assets from its vendors. But instead of paying the vendors in cash, the company will allot them debentures because the company may not have sufficient cash at the moment. So the issue of debentures to vendors is known as issue of debentures for consideration other than cash. In such cases, it will be consideration other than cash because you would have purchased machinery or fixed assets, some other fixed assets. You are supposed to give them cash, but instead of cash, we are now allotting them debentures. So let us look at this entry. X Limited purchased furniture from Messrs. A and Co. for rupees 1 lakh. First, we have to pass the entry for purchase of fixed asset. In this case, sundry assets or debit furniture account to Messrs. A and Co. Limited. So what we are doing is sundry assets is nothing but, as the name itself says, is an asset or the furniture. Increase in asset, as the asset rule says, should be debited. So we are debiting 1 lakh. Then credit the liability because we were supposed to give them money but we haven't yet given them anything. Therefore, credit 1 lakh. Then we have to pass another entry for issue of debentures for consideration other than cash. In that case, what would happen is debit Messrs. A and Co. because we are now allotting them debentures. How much? 1 lakh. And credit what? Credit debentures. Again, 1 lakh. So now what happened? The liability which had increased is now getting decreased because we have now allotted them debentures. And a new liability is increasing, that is debentures account. Debentures issued as a collateral security. Additional security for loans obtained maybe from financial institutions like banks, etc. Collateral security, as the name itself says, is additional security given for a loan. When company obtains a loan, it may issue its own debentures to the lenders as collateral security against the security in addition to any other security. First of all, we have to give some other security. On top of that, we are issuing them debentures. In such case, the lender has absolute right over the debentures until the loan is repaid. So, for example, let's say Kingfisher Limited obtains a loan from SBI Limited, that is the SBI Bank. So the Kingfisher company would have given some security. On top of that, Kingfisher company is now issuing debentures as collateral security or additional security so that if there is any default, the company SBI can encash those debentures. On repayment of the loan, the lender is legally bound to release the debentures. See, for example, if the Kingfisher had repaid the loan, SBI would have released such debentures which were issued as collateral security. If the loan is not repaid or if there is any breach of agreement, the lender has the right to retain those debentures. That means if the receiver of the loan does not repay the amount due to the lender, then the lender will then encash those debentures and try to realize them. And one thing has to be remembered, though those are debentures, they do not carry any interest. The interest is to be paid only on the loan obtained, not on the debentures issued as collateral security. So there are two ways of accounting for debentures issued as collateral security. One is, of course, because it's a debenture which is issued only as a collateral security, meaning it can be realized only in case of default. Unless there is any default, there is no question of realizing the same. Therefore, it will be completely out of the books. For example, let's say X Limited issued 1000 10% debentures of rupees 100 each as collateral security for a bank loan taken of rupees 80,000. In this case, there won't be any entry because if you can look at the balance sheet, there is current liability bank loan of 80,000. There is no collateral security of debentures. The other method is to record the same in the books. In this case, what we do is we will record it as debenture suspense account. That is, in case of default, that debenture will be realized. Therefore, the entry in this case would be debenture suspense account debit to 10% debentures account. So now, if you look at the extract of the balance sheet, so what will happen is, okay, before that, at the time of repayment, this reversal entry will be passed because we had debited debenture suspense. Now that the loan has been cleared, we will clear that debenture suspense. Now, if you look at the extract of balance sheet in the second method where debenture entry is recorded, you can notice that there is long-term borrowing, 1 lakh, which is nothing but debentures issued as collateral security. Against that, there is a corresponding asset called the debenture suspense account. These two will set one against the other. These two will set off one against the other. So if you remove these two, then it becomes the first method wherein we are not recording anything at all. Now let us look at interest on debentures. As we already noted, interest needs to be paid whether or not the company is making profits. It's a charge against the profit. It's not an appropriation of profit, unlike the dividend. It's paid at a fixed percentage, therefore you usually see the 10% debenture, 12% debentures. Those are nothing but the interest rates to be paid to debenture holders. And we have to also note that interest has to be paid on the nominal value of the debenture, not at the issue price. The issue price could be 150 rupees instead of 100 or 90 rupees instead of 100. But the company has to pay the interest on the nominal value itself, that is rupees 100, if that is the nominal value. If the debentures are tax-free, then it is the responsibility of the company to pay such tax on the interest on such debentures. And until and unless TDS payable is deposited by the company with the government, it will be treated as liability and shown as current liability in the balance sheet. Meaning, the company is supposed to pay interest and on that interest, they have to deduct TDS. And once such TDS is deducted, the company has to pay to the central government. If it is not paid, then it will be treated as current liability in the balance sheet. Or till it is paid, it will be shown under current liabilities. Now let us look at an example regarding interest on debentures. X Limited issued 1,000 10% debentures of rupees 100 each on 1st April 2004. Interest is to be paid half yearly. In this case, the company is paying interest once in 6 months, assuming tax rate to be 30%. Here, the company is supposed to deduct TDS at the rate of 30% and deposit the same on behalf of those debenture holders with the central government. So let us look at the interest due portion first. Debenture interest account. Debenture interest account has to be debited because it's an expenditure being incurred by the company. So 1,000 debentures into 100 rupees, because debenture interest is always calculated on the nominal value, at 10%, as the name itself says, it is 10%, into 6 by 12, because it is being paid half yearly. So it comes to 5,000. Two, TDS account. Here it's a liability because the company need not pay entire 5,000 to the debenture holders. It will only pay 3,500. Therefore, the due entry is created only to the extent of 3,500. The remaining 1,500 will be treated as liability, that is TDS. So then comes the payment. Once we create the due entry, the next immediate entry would be the payment. In this case, the debenture holders will get, as we saw earlier, 3,500 instead of 5, because 1,500 is the TDS made by the company. So debenture holders debit to bank credit because asset is decreasing and this is a liability which is getting decreased. Liability getting decreased and asset getting decreased. If liability decreases, it should be debited, and if asset decreases, it should be credited. This is the rules of accounting. Once again, for those who are not familiar with these modern accounting rules, it's very simple. We divide the accounts into 4 or 5 different categories based on how you classify asset, liability, expenditure and income. Sometimes even capital will be treated, but capital can also be part of liability. Now, asset rule. Very simple. If asset increases, it has to be debited. If asset decreases, it needs to be credited. Liability is the opposite. If liability increases, it needs to be credited. If liability decreases, it needs to be debited. Expenditure rule. Same as asset. Increase in expenditure, debit. Decrease in expenditure, credit. Income, same as liability. Increase in income, credit. Decrease in income, debit. That's it. Capital has the same rule as liability. Now, in this case, payment of TDS to the government. So, this TDS, which was earlier created as a liability, is now getting reduced. Therefore, debit TDS. And since asset is decreasing, credit bank account. Transfer of debenture interest to profit and loss account at the end of the year. Since it's an expenditure, it needs to be treated as so. Since it's an expenditure, it needs to be treated as such. Therefore, we are transferring that to P&L account and exhausting the debenture interest account. Whatever was debited here is now transferred to P&L account. You might wonder why it is 10,000. Very simple. The same entry will be passed twice during the year. Every 6 months, they are supposed to pay the interest. Therefore, it has now become 10,000.